Hey folks, welcome to Digimento Education. Welcome to yet another interesting video lecture on Engineering Mathematics. This is Engineering Mathematics Lecture 6. Hopefully you are all doing great and continuously revising the concepts that I covered in the last 5 lectures. If you haven't gone through them, I suggest you to go through them first and then hop on to this particular video lecture. Otherwise you will not be able to get the real essence of what I am going to teach in the subsequent lectures. I am a course instructor, Utkarsh Upadhyay. Hopefully so continuous revision is a must, is the key to success. Okay, so if you really like the video, please hit the like button, share and subscribe to our channel and write down your comments below in the comment section. If you have any doubts, please write them down in the comment section below. We will surely get back to you with the solutions, and if required, we can make a separate video on that, stating your doubts. So in the last lecture, basically I ended the discussion on the introduction to the eigenvalues and eigenvectors, and I also solved some previous year's gate questions based on the concepts that I covered on based on the concepts of eigenvalues and eigenvectors. In this lecture, I am going to start off with some properties related to eigenvalues and eigenvectors, which are very very important, and it is very very important for you to keep these properties in mind, because you can expect a hell lot of theoretical questions from this particular topic as well, along with the numerical problems. Okay, so let me start off with this. So some important results on eigenvalues. And vectors. Okay. So let me write multiple points on that. So first one. So if X is a characteristic vector. If X is a characteristic vector of a matrix A, okay, then X cannot be. Then X cannot be the eigenvector cannot correspond to more than one characteristic values of A. So for each eigenvalue we have an eigenvector. Okay, you cannot have the same eigenvector for multiple eigenvalues. Okay, for distinct eigenvalues we cannot have that. Okay, so if for a matrix A of size n cross n has n distinct eigenvalues, this line is very very important. If a matrix of size n cross n has n distinct eigenvalues, then there will be n linearly independent eigenvectors. Okay, this line is very very important. If a matrix A has unique eigenvalues, then there will be as many unique linearly independent eigenvectors. However, if the n eigenvalues, but if the n eigenvalues are not distinct, some are repetitive, okay, then there may or may not be n linearly independent eigenvectors. Okay? This line is very, very important. Okay? Now, the third point. The eigenvalues of a Hermitian matrix are real. The eigenvalues of Hermitian matrix are real. Okay? Fourth, the eigenvalues of symmetric, or you can say real symmetric matrix, are all real. Okay, are all real, since every such matrix is a Hermitian. Okay, so these two points are also very, very important. The eigenvalues of a Hermitian as well as real symmetric matrix are all real. The fifth point. The eigenvalues. The eigenvalues of a skew Hermitian matrix. Skew Hermitian matrix are either zero or purely imaginary. It is also worth noting that in skew Hermitian matrix, the elements in the principal diagonal are also either zero or purely imaginary. Okay? The sixth point. The eigenvalues of a real skew symmetric matrix are either zero or purely imaginary, as for every such matrix is skew Hermitian. Okay? The seventh point. The eigenvalues of unitary matrix, or you can say unitary, which is basically UU star is equal to a unitary matrix, are of unit modulus. That is, modulus of lambda is always equal to 1, which is basically UU conjugate is equal to I. This was your unitary matrix. Eighth, the eigenvalues of an orthogonal matrix is A transpose is equal to I, or A transpose A is equal to I, is also of unit modulus, since every such matrix is unitary. Okay, I think these properties seem to be very daunting for you, but they are not that difficult. As I mentioned earlier, when I started off with the linear algebra chapter, that the concepts are going to be a little bit tricky but not difficult to remember. Okay, if you are in a process of continuous revision of these concepts, then you will not face any problem in remembering the concepts. So it all depends on you, how you basically prudently manage your time for the subjects that you are going to prepare for the GATE examination. It all depends on you. It all depends on your timetable and schedule that you have prepared for yourself. If you haven't prepared the schedule for yourself yet, I suggest you to prepare a schedule for that, otherwise, and stick to, try to stick to that. Don't deviate from the schedule that you have prepared for yourself. Otherwise, this would create the chaos and hodgepodge and the farrago of confusion at the end. Okay, now let's basically start off with some properties of eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So these were some results that we discussed in greater depth. Now let's study about some properties of eigenvalues and eigenvectors, which are very, very important. So properties of eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Okay. Now let's write them one by one, and let's just quickly have a look at those properties. Okay, so we are considering that let's say lambda 1 and lambda 2, lambda n. First of all, I'm just generalizing the concept that lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 up to lambda n are eigenvalues of the matrix A of order n cross n. Then k lambda 1, k lambda 2, and so on up to k lambda n are eigenvalues of the matrix k A. Okay. Second, 1 by lambda 1, 1 by lambda 2, 1 by lambda 3 up to 1 by lambda n are eigenvalues of the matrix A inverse. Okay. 3. Eigenvalues lambda 1, lambda 2 up to lambda n are also the eigenvalues of values of A transpose. Okay. Fourth one, lambda 1 to the power k, lambda 2 to the power k up to lambda n to the power k are the eigenvalues of A to the power k matrix. Okay. Fifth, determinant of A divided by lambda 1, determinant of A divided by lambda 2 up to determinant of A divided by lambda n are eigenvalues of adjoint of the matrix A. Understood? Sixth, lambda 1 minus k, lambda 2 minus k up to lambda n minus k are eigenvalues of the matrix A minus ki. Okay. Total possible or maximum possible distinct eigenvalues of matrix A is equal to the size of A. Okay, so as I just mentioned that if the matrix is of the size n cross n, is a square matrix, then the maximum possible distinct eigenvalues of that particular matrix is n. Okay, lambda 1 to lekar lambda n. Eighth, sum of the eigenvalues is equal to the trace of the matrix A. Ninth, product of eigenvalues is equal to the determinant of matrix A. Okay. Tenth, in a triangular matrix, in a triangular or diagonal matrix. In a triangular or diagonal matrix, eigenvalues are the elements at the principal diagonal. Okay, so in a triangular or the diagonal matrix, eigenvalues are the elements at the principal diagonals. Okay, if A and B are two matrices, if A and B are two matrices of the same order, then the matrix AB and BA will have same eigenvalues. Okay? 12th, eigenvectors of A square, A to the power R, A inverse, KA are all the same. Okay? They are all the same. But eigenvectors of A and A transpose are distinct or not the same. Okay? 13th point, this is important. For a symmetric matrix A, there exist exactly n, not necessarily distinct, eigenvalues. Okay, B, there exists a set of n eigenvectors, one for each eigenvalue, that is basically one for each eigenvalue. That are mutually orthogonal. This property is very, very important for a symmetric matrix It's basically a square matrix, let's say of order n cross n. Then there basically exist n not necessarily distinct eigenvalues, and corresponding to each eigenvalue, there exist eigenvectors. And all the eigenvectors are mutually orthogonal to each other. This is the property which you need to keep in mind, because the questions had already been asked in the previous GATE examinations based on this concept. Okay. So this is all about the properties. I have discussed them in greater details. Now it's all up to you to remember these properties and try to continuously revise these concepts. Otherwise, these concepts may fade away in your brain, and at the later stage, you may face difficulty in remembering the concepts. You may be required to go through the whole whole subject once again, and it will basically consume ample of time. So keep revising these concepts, because these concepts are very, very important. Now let's veer across some important GATE examples, so that it will make it more clear to you, so that the concepts will make your concepts more clearer to you. Okay, let's have a look at this question. For the matrix A, this one of the normalized eigenvectors is given as this. So the other options which was asked in Mechanical Engineering GATE 2012 paper. So first thing first, let's say we know that the A matrix is 5 3 1 3. First of all, let's find out the eigenvalues. It will be 5 minus lambda, 3 1, 3 minus lambda. Determinant of this thing should be equal to 0. because let's write the a minus lambda I is basically a characteristic equation. Okay, it's not a polynomial, it's a characteristic equation as discussed in the last class. So you are quite familiar with these things now. I am hoping that is equal to 0. So if you solve, you get lambda is equal to 2 and lambda is equal to 6. You get the two eigenvalues. Now the eigenvectors that we will find across for these eigenvalues, the eigenvectors corresponding to these eigenvalues will be linearly independent. Okay, as discussed a couple of minutes ago. So to find out the eigenvectors, now a minus lambda I, let's say x cap must be equal to zero vector, which is basically your 5 minus lambda. This was your 1, 3, 3 minus lambda matrix x is equal to 0. Now let's say lambda is equal to 2. Let's find out let's find an eigenvector corresponding to lambda is equal to 2. So we are left with 5 minus 2 is 3, 3, 1, 3 minus 2 is 1. X is equal to 0. If we apply R2 as R2 as 3 R2 minus R1, we get 3, 3, 0, 0. And this will be, let's say, x1 and x2 is equal to 0, 0. Okay. So from here, we get 3x1 plus 3x2 is equal to 0, which implies that we get x1 plus x2 is equal to 0. So rank of this matrix, since there exists non-trivial solutions for this particular matrix, then which implies that the rank of this matrix is less than the order or the number of variables. Okay, so nullity is basically in this case is 1, rank is also 1, nullity is 1. So in n minus r, independent variables, n minus r is 3, minus 1 is n minus r, 2 minus 1 is 1. So there is only one independent variable. Okay, let us take x2, let x2 be k, so we get x1 as minus k. Okay, so the eigenvector corresponding to this will be x1, x2, this will be equal to x1 is minus k and k, this will be equal to k times of minus 1 and plus 1. Okay. Now we need to find out the normalized eigenvector. Normalized eigenvector is, so we have the normalized eigenvector is basically your x cap divided by mod x. Okay, this will be equal to square root of minus k square plus k square into minus k. This will come out to be minus 1 by square root of 2, 1 by square root of 2. Okay, so does this basically match to any of the answers that we have? So no, we don't have so 1 by root 2 and minus 1 by root 2. Yes, we can say that 1 by root 2 and minus 1 by root 2, here we do not get minus 1 by, here we are getting minus 1 by root 2 to 1 by root 2. So this is not in the options. So we have to find out the eigenvector corresponding to lambda is equal to 6 as well. So now let is equal to lambda is equal to 6. Okay. So for corresponding to that, we get minus 1, 3, 1, minus 3, x1, x2 is equal to 0, 0. So what we can do, we can just simply add R2 plus R1. We get minus 1, 3, 0, 0. x1, x2. There exist non-trivial solutions. Okay, so we get minus x1 plus 3x2 is equal to 0. Let's say, let us take x2 as k. Let x2 is as k. So if x2 is equal to k, we get x1 as x1 will be equal to 3k. Okay, so the eigenvector corresponding to that x2 cap will be equal to x1 x2 will be equal to 3k. Okay, and this will come out to be equal to k times of 3 1. The normalized eigenvector x2 cap by mod x cap is equal to 1 by 4 plus, so 1 by 3k square 9 plus 1, it will be equal to square root of 3k square plus k square 3k k. This will come out to be 3 by 2 1 by 2. So we don't have this option. So we can say, we can basically approximate that since no eigenvector is basically come out to be from the given options, but the eigenvector that we got earlier, which is this minus 1 by root 2 and plus 1 by root 2, it's quite resembles to the option B. So we can go with the option B. So option B is correct for this particular question. Okay, let's have a look at another question. Let's have a look at this question. The matrix has eigenvalues minus 1 and minus 2. The corresponding eigenvectors are 1 and minus 1 and 1 and minus 2 respectively. The matrix is, so we have to determine the matrix. How to do that? How to solve this question? We know the characteristic equation as Ax is equal to lambda x. It's basically a eigenvalue problem. Okay. Let A be any matrix. Let's say A, B, C, D. So we basically write A, B, C, D can take any of these, any value. Okay. So let's say, for this first eigenvalue, so we can write A, B, C, D, X. Let's say corresponding to lambda is equal to minus 1. This eigenvector is 1 and minus 1 should be equal to minus 1 times A is equal to lambda x. Lambda x is 1 and minus 1. Okay. If we solve this, you get A minus B is equal to minus 1 and C minus D as plus 1. Okay. Now, corresponding to lambda is equal to minus 2, we have A, B, C, D. Its eigenvector corresponding to this is 1 and minus 2. We have 1 and minus 2 is equal to minus 2 times 1 and minus 2. If you solve for this, you get A minus 2B is equal to minus 2. C minus 2D is equal to 4. Okay. So we have two equations, two variables. We have two equations, two variables. We can solve for A, B, C, D. So we get let's say 3, and this is 4, this is 1, and this is 2. So on solving 1 and 3, on solving 1 and 3, we get A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1. And on solving 2 and 4, we get C is equal to minus 2 and D is equal to minus 3. So the matrix that we finally get, A, B, C, D, is 0, 1, minus 2 and minus 3. 0, so the option D satisfies the answer. The option D satisfies. Okay, let's have a look at another question. Let's have a look at this example. The maximum value of A such that the matrix this has three linearly independent real eigenvectors is. So we have to select one of these options. Okay. So first, A minus lambda I should be equal to 0, characteristic equation. Let's find out the eigenvalue. So this will be equal to 3 minus lambda, 0, minus 2, 1, minus 1, minus lambda, 0, 0, A, minus 2, minus lambda. This should be equal to 0. If you open this thing up, you get minus of 3 plus lambda times 1 plus lambda into 2 plus lambda minus 0 minus 2a minus 0 is equal to 0. So from here we get 2a as minus times of lambda cube plus 6 lambda square plus 11 lambda plus 6. Okay, now we need to find out the maximum value of A. Okay, so for that, for maxima and minima, 2dA by d lambda must be equal to 0, which comes out to be equal to minus of 3 lambda square plus 12 lambda plus 11. Okay, so if we solve this quadratic equation, that is 3 lambda square plus 12 lambda plus 11 is equal to 0, we get lambda as minus 12 plus minus square root of 144 minus 132 divided by 6, which is minus 2 plus minus 1 by square root of 3. And lambda, from here we get minus 2 plus 1 by square root of 3. So for this particular value, we get the maximum value, where 2 times of a will be equal to minus of minus 2 plus 1 by root 3 plus 1 minus 2 plus 1 by root 3 plus 2, get minus 2 plus 1 by root 3 of plus 3. Okay, if we keep on solving this, we get 2a times of 2 by 3 into 1 by square root of 3, and from here we get 1 by a as 1 by 3 root 3. 1 by 3 root 3 is B option. So the option B is correct. Option B is correct. Let's have a look at another example. Let's have a look at this example. The value of x for which all the eigenvalues of the matrix given below are real. Okay. So this is basically this particular matrix that we have. So we have to choose one of these options available. Okay. So given below are real. The eigenvalues need to be real. So there are two possibilities which arise. First one is that the matrix is a symmetric matrix or the matrix is Hermitian matrix. Okay, so in this case, as we can see, it includes a complex number j as a complex number 5 plus j. So we can use the concept of Hermitian matrix. Okay, we can use the concept of Hermitian matrix. Okay, because for a Hermitian or the symmetric matrix, eigenvalues are real. Okay, so we applying the property of Hermitian matrix. Okay, which is basically A is equal to A conjugate or A is equal to A theta or A is equal to A conjugate transpose. We apply the same concept here. So we know the matrix A as 10, 5 plus J, 4, X, 20, 2, 4, 2, minus 10. Okay. Now this should be equal to A conjugate transpose. This comes out to be equal to 10, 5 minus J, 4, X conjugate, 20, 2, 4, 2, minus 10. Okay, is this clear? So we can say on, since both of these are equal, these two matrices hold the equality, so we can say X conjugate is equal to 5 plus J or X is equal to 5 minus J. From here we get X is equal to 5 minus J. So X will be your 5 minus J. B satisfies the answer. Okay, let's have a look at another question. Now let's have a look at this cleverly asked question. Consider the 5 cross 5 matrix below. This is the matrix given to us. It is given that A has only one real eigenvalue. Then the real eigenvalue of A is what? So we have to select one of these options. One of these options is correct. Okay. So if you try to apply your research type of mind in this question, you won't be able to get the answer. You have to use the other side of your brain, which is basically your sharp brain or the clever brain. So in order to answer the clever question, you have to apply your clever part of your brain. You cannot find out the eigenvalue just applying Ax is equal to lambda x or A minus lambda I determinant is equal to 0. Because you won't be able to solve this big determinant. It's a 5 cross 5 matrix. You cannot easily solve the determinant of this particular matrix. So it's pretty difficult. Even if you apply an elementary row operation on this, you won't be able to get the answer in time. So if you apply your mind, this question only can be answered in just 32 in just a matter of 30 to 40 seconds. Okay, so we know that Ax is equal to lambda x. Do we know this thing? Yes, we know that Ax is equal to lambda x is a basic eigenvalue problem. We are just going to use this. So we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4, 5, 1, 2, 3. Then we have 3, 4, 5, 1, 2. 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. Okay, let's say the eigenvector or the X matrix is x1, x2, x3, x4 and x5, okay, is equal to lambda times of x1, x2, x3, x4 and x5. Okay, let's open these things, up. Okay, if you want to open it up, you get x1 plus 2x2 plus 3x3 plus 4x4 plus 5x5 is equal to lambda times of x1. Then we have 5x1 plus x2 plus 2x3 plus 3x4 plus 4x5 is equal to lambda times of x2. Then we get 4x1 plus 5x2 plus x3 plus 2x4 plus 3x5 is equal to lambda x3. Then we have 3x1 plus 4x2 plus 5x3 plus x4 plus 2x5 is equal to lambda x4. Okay, then we have 2x1, then we have 2x1 plus 3x2 plus 4x3 plus 5x4 plus 5x4 plus x5 is equal to lambda x5. Okay, now add all the equations. Add all the equations. What do we get? 5 plus 4 is 9 plus 3, 12. 12 plus 2 is 14 plus 1 is 15. We get 15x1 plus 2 plus 1, 3 plus 5, 8 plus 4, 12 plus 3 is 15. 15x2 plus 15x3 plus 15x4 plus 15x5 is equal to lambda times of x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus x5. We get 15 times of x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus x5 is equal to lambda times of x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 plus x5. This will cancel with this. So lambda is equal to 15 is the only answer, only solution. So C is equal to 15 is the answer to this question. Okay, let's have a look at another example. Let's have a look at this example. The determinant of this matrix A is what? Okay, where A is basically given to us, where A is basically this matrix, which is 6 cross 6 matrix. So it's pretty difficult to find out the determinant of this matrix A by just applying the determinant formula, which is basically, okay. So what if we apply some elementary row operations and try to reduce it to the simpler form, okay. So if we apply R6 minus 2R1, if we apply R5 to R5 minus 2R1 and R4 as R4 minus 2R3. This matrix will basically boil down to 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 2. We get 0, 1, 0, 0, 2, 0. We get 0, 0, 1, 2, 0, 0. Then we get 0, 0, 0, minus 3, 0, 0. Then we get 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 3, 0. And then we get 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 3. Okay. This is the matrix that we are left with at the end. Now, this becomes a triangular matrix. It's an upper triangular matrix. The determinant is equal to the product of the elements in its principal diagonal. So, determinant of this matrix A will be equal to 1 into 1 into 1 into minus 3 into minus 3 into minus 3. And this comes out to be minus 27. Just to make a note, here that eigenvalues of A may or may not be equal to its the eigenvalue of its equivalent matrix. Okay? Okay. Now we are going to start off with the another most important concept of linear algebra is the Cayley-Hamilton theorem. Let me put the heading Cayley-Hamilton theorem. Cayley-Hamilton okay, this is basically an effective way of finding out the inverse of a matrix. Okay, this is also an effective way of finding out the inverse of a matrix. So it is an interesting way of finding out the inverse of a matrix. Okay, the statement of this theorem is every square matrix satisfies its own characteristic equation. This is what it says. Every square matrix satisfies its own characteristic equation. Okay, which is A minus lambda I, determinant should be equal to 0. So this means that if C naught lambda to the power n plus C1 lambda to the power n minus 1 and so on and so forth up to Cn minus 1 lambda plus Cn is equal to 0. Let's say this is basically a characteristic equation in terms of its eigenvalues. Is basically if is a characteristic equation, then for every square matrix A of order n, then for every square matrix of order n, C0 A to the power n plus C1 A to the power n minus 1 and so on up to Cn minus 1 A plus Cn is equal to 0 will be Cn into I will be equal to 0. This is satisfied. Okay, it's just that you replace lambda with A and 1 with I. Okay, replace lambda with A and 1 with I. That's it. Okay, and where this is basically a null matrix. This is basically a null matrix. Okay. Okay, folks, I'm stopping this lecture here. This was basically an introduction to the Cayley-Hamilton theorem. We shall dive deep into this concept in the next lecture. Till then, please go through the concepts that I covered in this lecture as well as in the last four lectures. Okay, if you have any doubt, please write them down in the comment section below. We shall surely get back to you with the solutions. Thank you very much.